contemplating imperfections, or so-called imperfections. Contemplating the various failures, faults, missed opportunities, mishandled situations in my life, and especially the ones that seem to be repeating patterns. I see that I have negative tendencies. Some have roots in my history, my upbringing, my personality, my fears, in my aspirations, in my skill set or lack of certain skills, while others seem to be patterns that I cannot trace their origins. Similarly, everyone has similar patterns, imperfections, unique to their circumstances, but each one of us has disappointments, failures, unskillful acts. And naturally, my imperfections and the imperfections of others will clash. Accepting my own negative tendencies, I also accept the negative tendencies of all beings. And I contemplate the possibility that each being has at some point been my mother, in whatever incarnation, in whatever state. In some ways, I am that closely related to each being. Can I see all beings in the same light as I see the one who's most precious to me, the one I love? Can I love all beings more than I love myself? Contemplating the idea that the happiness of others is more important than my own happiness, simply because there are so many more others and only one me. And noting the analysis, the chatter that is presented to the mind when we contemplate that statement. seeing the difficulty in prioritizing the happiness of others, and seeing my tendency to prioritize my happiness, and that I do not always understand what makes me truly happy, I recognize the need for signposts that remind me of the happiness of others and how to avoid making them suffer. Contemplating the guidelines given by the Buddha and many traditions, ahimsa, nonviolence, not killing, asteya, not stealing, brahmacharya, sexual restraint, satya, truthfulness, aparigraha, non-greed, or moderating consumption. So adjust your posture. We'll continue to sit a few more moments, contemplating the five precepts, mindfulness trainings, with a view of using them as signposts, as a reminder of the happiness of myself and the happiness of others. Do not kill. Do not let others kill. Find whatever means possible to protect life. Do not live with a vocation that is harmful to humans and nature. The second signpost Do not steal. Possess nothing that should belong to others. Respect the property of others, but prevent others from enriching themselves, from human suffering, and the suffering of other species on Earth. Sexual expression should not take place without love and a long-term commitment. Be fully aware of the suffering you may cause others as a result of your conduct. To preserve the happiness of yourself and others, respect the rights and commitments of others. Do not say things that are untrue. Do not spread news that you do not know to be certain. Do not criticize or condemn things that you are not sure of. Do not utter words that cause division and hatred, that can create discord and cause the family or the community to break. All efforts should be made to reconcile and resolve conflicts. Do not use alcohol or any other intoxicant. Be aware that your fine body has been transmitted to you by your parents and several previous generations. To destroy your body with alcohol or other intoxicants is to betray your ancestors, parents, and future generations.